how's it going? Welcome back to another episode of the 2-Hour Grind. I'm Nate, and today I'm going to be continuing this blade piece that I worked on yesterday. So I penciled it on a piece of paper, didn't quite like the placement, going to transfer it to a better piece of paper. So that's the step that I'm at today. So I got my sketch from yesterday, I've got the paper that I'm going to use for today. I'm actually going to go a little bit bigger piece of paper, and go through, I'm going to get through pencils, going to get through some inks hopefully, and maybe some markers on top of that as well. All depends on how things play out. And this is already, why every time, I swear, every time I start, my camera wants to get slow. So, line it up, give him that extra room that I needed him to have. Give him that extra room that I want to give him over on the side, right? So I want to be able to fit his whole foot. So I'm going to slide the paper.
Sorry, I'm still not sure about that.
Okay. So that's what I'm going to be working on today for the 2-hour grind. And tune in, see the progress if you like watching people draw. This is going to be uploaded on later on. You know, you'll see it on YouTube, whatever. Fast forward through it. I'm going to start to speed them up as well. I know you can push the playback and double the speed on some of them, so I'm not seeing the eraser. That's what I need. Just that. Just this one. There's not a lot there anyway. Okay. Alright, try to fix a couple of anatomy things, too, that I didn't quite like while I am changing it up. Sometimes doing light box and transitioning or, you know, tracing your own work onto another piece of paper, I sometimes lose the energy of the first sketch, which is kind of tough. Sometimes when you're rolling on a sketch and you get something and you really like it, and then you try to put it on a nicer piece of paper or something, and it doesn't always turn out as crisp as the original. So hopefully I can pull it off. I'm trying not to, like, go too dark on the sketch that I'm doing now, but it's just kind of tracing what I already put down. Light boxes are an awesome way, especially to do inks on a, when you go to inking. I always re-pencil before I ink. I don't know, it's just, I like the penciled look way more than the ink look sometimes. And that's one of the things that I like to do. So, to each their own though. Some people will just go straight to inks on top of this. And I could do that too. I just prefer pencils. Alright, so I'm going to keep this side as is. I'm going to tweak the other side a little bit. Once I get there. All right. So, took the original sketch. And redrew it on a new piece of paper. So, light boxes, awesome use. For inking, getting transferring it to another piece of paper, you make a big mistake on, maybe you're painting something, you make a mistake, but you really like the line work, and you want to take, you know, save some, you know, use the light table, try to trace it out. It doesn't shine through everything, but, you know, hopefully it would. Would be salvageable a little bit. All right, so I got the layers in.
Thank you.
So it's kind of a rooftop he's standing on. So that's kind of what I'm going for. So I transferred that blade picture. Now I'm just working on re-penciling it. I'm going to add those extra details. And hopefully get into some inks on them. Maybe he's been fighting. Maybe I'll put some battle. I'll probably put some battle damage type of deal on his armor. He's got his arm up. He's about to toss one of the stakes at some vampires, fighting some vampires on a rooftop. I don't know. Blade the Vampire Hunter, right? Marvel Comics. I hope that show gets off its feet eventually. I know they've been talking about Mahershala Ali. I hope I said that right. Anyway, they've been talking about him being in his own Blade TV show. I'm not sure when it drops or comes out, but kind of looking forward to it. Okay. All right, first layers getting laid down. I go back over them a second time. Sometimes I change the pencil lead. I've been using the 2H pencil lead in this pencil. I know it looks like a normal Bic, but I switch it out. Probably should just go to a darker pencil at this point. But I want to start inking, I think. I could just jump into inking. So sometimes I'll go into a different lead. Ran into the lid on that one, so. All right. Next steps. I guess I'm going to do a little eraser. Never did locate there. That's because I don't know. I really hope Marvel's TV could pull off some of those horror. That Werewolf by Night was pretty rad that came out. I like to see something different than just the superhero stuff sometimes. Kind of fix the hand. So he's kind of coming up. He's going to be throwing a stake at a vampire. Try to stake him in the heart, right? I don't know. Fighting vampires on a rooftop. That's about as far as I got. So. Now, this marker's almost like dead, so it's kind of gives it a nice textured line. So I'm gonna hit it with that first, and then I'll go over the extra black line again a second time with a better brush marker. Gonna mainly just do the outside edge. I will get some of the lines, or the detailed lines as well, with this brush, because it's kind of like a gray almost. It's not really as dark. So I'm gonna use it till it dies, and then I'll switch it up to the solid. So we'll just kind of go in with the black ink pen, kind of just hitting the line work. It's going to probably take this layer, one more layer on top, I imagine. Just to start separating some of the elements a little bit more. So I did it a little different than I normally work. Kind of was experimenting with the loose line work with the brush pen that was almost dried out, so it left kind of like textured lines, and you might not be able to see so much of like the textured lines, but they're kind of textured and they're not quite full. So now I'm going in and using the pen to kind of fill in the ones that need to be, but leaving that texture in some areas as well. So just adding details, right? Going in, really just inking the line work at this point. Kind of already threw some of the gray tones in just for fun, just to place the light where the light sources are hitting and kind of play with that a little bit. So that's a little bit different than my normal work. Usually I would just work all the way up, building the layers slowly. I would have already inked it, line work, but wanted to try something different. So changing the method doesn't really change the outcome a whole lot so far. But it's also, if you would have made a mistake while you're doing that first layer of shadows, then you could, you know, adjust the lines where they fall to, which makes it kind of cool doing it that way. So this is the 2 hour grind, and this is basically me trying to draw, hold myself accountable for drawing every day. 2 hours. I don't always hit the 2 hour mark, but I try. And I don't always hit every day, but I try. Right, got some blade action happening on the 2 hour grind. I am just inking right now, going over the line work, trying to get some of those elements to separate, pull things forward, push things back, add some change of value here and there, right, to try to create those forms. in the right way. Tweak it a little bit, fix a little bit of the line there. All right, little blade for today's 2-hour grind. Ran through it rather quickly in some aspects. I do want to... It's not quite done yet, so think you should probably have gloves on, right? I don't think he's running around bare-fisted, is he? Probably has gloves. My guess is gloves. Gloves, gloves, gloves. '70s blade, no. Modern blade, some. Movie blade, yes. building layers with the markers, grayscale, just going over top of it, over and over. Going to need quite a few more layers. However, I think I'm going to call it on this today's two-hour grind. I got to this point. Tune in if you want to see the next steps. It's just going to be continuing to add the value change, extra layers, right? Light to dark. Really work on that light source. So I got a light source coming in from the side currently. I want to keep that going. I'm going to add the roof, brick wall, like stone, the old castle looking wall. He's going to be, you know, he's fighting with vampires on a roof, and I'm going to put a couple vampires probably jumping around in the background or something once I get there. So thanks for tuning in. If you did, to the 2-hour grind, I'm Nate from GCP Comics. Give us a like, give us a follow at all those cool spots. That little bit of support would be super awesome. That's all it takes. Just a little like, just a little follow. And thanks for tuning in. If you did, catch some of my older videos, and some of the new videos will be also posted on YouTube. So easy, just jump around and see the next steps where it ends up. So I'm Nate, GCP Comics. Thanks again for tuning in. Until next.